is a great feeling. It's feeling, you know, like homecoming. And when I was sharing with my staff members in the morning, the team, because a large number of team is still here, what they used to be. And I did share that when I left, maybe I was not feeling so confident, but many of them were feeling very confident that I will have a reincarnation and I'll come back here in a different capacity. So I must say their confidence was really touching and overwhelming. So it's a great feeling. I think without any division of view, there was a very clear view from and the clear feeling from all the customers that Baroda, and under the present leadership also, is keeping its tradition intact, careful for the customers. And what is appreciated that, you know, when they are dealing with Bank of Baroda, they are dealing with the person with flesh, blood and emotions, and not only a mechanical feeling of the, so that was a clear feeling. And they were also very, you know, so thankful, because a banker's taste is in time when there are difficulties for the customers. In good times, there won't be any dearth of customers. But in time of stress, a bank which can hold the hand of customer, that is always very important. And no businessman can claim that there will always be a benign cycle. There are always stressful time and good times in the business cycle. That was a very clear feeling. They were also appreciative of a continue the innovation which keeps on coming from the bank, whether it is the technology or the process or it is products. So they were also appreciative of that. That benign cycles and ups and down more for the customers. As far as the bank, see, of course, we are also a commercial organization. It keeps on happening. But the point I was trying to make that no customer or no business can claim that throughout their existence there would always be good times. In a business, there will always be time of difficulty. That is the nature of business. And the bank who come forward in time of such stress is the true test of it. That's what I think. As far as Baroda is concerned, globally there had been a time of stress. But I must say relatively. See, everything is relative in the real life. But relatively, we have come out quite strongly, whether it is globally or whether it is in the UK. UK, I must particularly compliment the present leadership that in a very challenging global environment, they have not only maintained the quality of the business, but have also been able to grow it. That is a relatively very short period. It is not much back in the history. But as I did mention, that there is a continuous innovation. And whatever is happening, the bank has been able to keep pace with it. But the basic character and fabric of the bank, it was, see, if you recollect, the Bank of Baroda in UK is more than 55 years old. It's not the entity which has come yesterday. And Bank of Baroda in India is 105 years old entity now. But what takes the bank constantly, you know, makes it strong and take it further, that some of the basic fabrics are always preserved. So I must say the same thing too for UK also. Basic fabrics is be a very conservative in your banking. Conservative doesn't mean that you don't do banking, but do a very careful banking. Be very considerate to your customers. Remain contemporary, because you can't do today's banking with yesterday's tools. You have to do today's banking with today's tools. So remain contemporary as far as the technology is concerned, products are concerned. But the one basic thing never forget, that customer is something which is a living entity. Customer is not a piece of furniture. So have that empathy for the customer. That is the basic fabric of it. Our, see, ambition is a journey. You can't have a short-term ambition or long-term ambition. But to give you a perspective, as far as India is concerned, Bank of Baroda in terms of business size is second largest bank in the country, only after the State Bank of India. Similarly, in overseas operations, Bank of Baroda again has the second largest network of overseas business, only after State Bank of India. This year only, in the month of March, we opened our 100th office, overseas office, that was in Dubai, and the finance minister of the country, Mr. P. Chidambaram, inaugurated it. So this is the situation where we are. We obviously want to maintain our leadership position, further strengthen it, but with good quality of business and good profitability. Growth not for the sake of growth. Now within overseas operation, without any reservation, UK is the most important piece of that.
Why is that?
It represents a large segment of overseas business and also profitability. Moreover, in respect of diversity of business, the number of branches, the spread, the customer base, in all that respect, UK stands out. So that is why it is very important, and I am very happy to see that within the Indian bank community, which is operating in UK, Bank of Baroda again, this is quite clearly a front runner, and a front runner with a considerable distance from the next runner. So, happy fun. I won't say it is my personal achievement. This is an achievement which has come with the successive leadership. And ultimately, if I look from that perspective, probably UK operations have been lucky that there was a succession of good leadership, and every leadership was conscious of the fact that while they have to do something while they are working here, but they also have to leave something for tomorrow, and this tradition has continued. That is what is the, so I won't say that is one man who has brought the situation as it is today. It's a collective effort of decades. It will be a very different thing. So, as far as India is concerned, India, as you know, is a large country, well diversified, and is a country where all the activities have a lot of scope to grow, because the country has come from the stage of underdeveloped to developing, and hopefully in a couple of decades it should be a fully developed country. So that being the case, there is a lot of activities on industry, in agro, because the agro value chain is getting created. Now demography is favorable. In India, as everyone knows, there is a huge young population. This young population is getting into the working class now. So obviously there is a great demand for the retail business and the retail loan products. And the SME, as we call them, small and medium enterprises, they were always a strength of India. To give you a perspective, the 45% of entire manufacturing goods in the country comes from the SME. 40% of the export of India comes from SME. So the point I am trying to make, that in all the areas in India, this being in a growth phase, there is an opportunity for everything. And our focus is almost divided, equally divided in each of these areas. As far as the UK is concerned, see, we have to be realistic. In UK, we are not a high street bank. Unlike India, where I have 4,500 outfits, UK, I can't have that. Limited outfit is there. So that being the case, our business here is more centric around the trade flow between India and UK, and also to some extent, the business which is being carried out by the ethnic company. Liking is one thing. See, you can have ambition and you can have dreams. Within dreams, you can have the normal dreams and you can have the daydreams. So I would not like to have a daydreams. I have the first hand experience, and if I see from that perspective, I came to UK in 2008. When I was here, you know. And Soon after I arrived, I think within 3-4 months, as they say, all hell broke loose. That was the time when global crisis started. We have seen the stress which is being felt by the business, and I must say with great satisfaction that at that point of time it was Bank of Baroda which came forward and did a lot of handling. It will be relevant to mention that during this journey of 50 years, many clients who originally started with us, and at some point of time they chose that now they have become too big to continue to deal with Bank of Baroda. Many of them moved away, maybe glamour or whatever it is. But they realized in 2008, and that is the point I come back, that the bank is one which do the hand-holding in time of difficulty. A large number of them came back because they realized that wherever they have gone, they were welcome as long as they were doing very well. They were no more welcome. So we continue with the same policy. I tell them 2-3 things. Some of them are relevant universally, some of them may be relevant more in the Indian context, but 3-4 things which I always tell particularly to SME. Number one, I always tell them leveraging is like blood pressure. It should not be very high, it can be fatal. It should not be very low, that will not be efficient. So the leveraging level, like you should have a right blood pressure, you should have a right leveraging in the business. That is the one thing. Second, I said deal in your core competence. If you are a manufacturer, that is your core competence. If you are a trader, selling is your core competency. Dealing in foreign exchange may not be your core competency. Dealing in structured product may not be your core competency. So don't get into something which is not your core competency. Third thing may not be so much relevant here, but which I always tell to my customers in India, that tax planning is your right. Do that. Tax evasion is not a right thing. Don't do that. And fourth thing which I mention, that, and I think it is more relevant in UK, but it will become relevant in India in a while, that while you do all the, you know, figure and the business and the planning for which is all revolving around the business figure, profit and loss, but time has come when you should also be very careful and think about the succession plan. Because the way things are changing in the society, few years back or maybe few decades back, it was taken for granted that the next generation will carry on the family business. Today and tomorrow it may not be same, it may not be true. So if that situation were to come, how would you deal with your existing business? That is something which one should plan for. I think these are the few things I have to mention. Exactly, because they have not seen this kind of situation. Now it's coming into the community very recently. Others have already seen it happening for last 3-4 decades. They have started preparing for it. But it will be useful for one to prepare for. See, it would be not correct to put all the banks under one umbrella. Banker is one word in dictionary, is a single word I know. In dictionary, banker is banker, but in real practice, the banking differs very, very usually from the banks who are doing everything but other than traditional banking, and bank like Bank of Baroda, which is only doing traditional banking and not doing anything else. So all those exotic products and the... If there were banks which were running the balance sheet which was greater than the GDP of Great Britain, and most of this balance sheet was not invested in the country, and if they... I'm not taking any names, I don't intend to take that name, but if they ended up doing a grave harm to the economy of the country, I think any anger against them is fully justified. So we have to see the perspective. Absolutely, as I said, this is our inherent philosophy for more than 100 years. So we would never venture for any adventurous banking. We would like to do the traditional banking, conservative. And since he has come from a different working environment, so the first impression which he has given is like a breeze of fresh air. So obviously the banking and business community is quite hopeful that he will bring a very pragmatic view, and he seems determined to bring more vibrancy in the market, in the money market or in the funding area. So that is what is expected. As far as the Indian economy is considered, I think absolutely there was no reason to feel so much of gloom and doom. Not denying the fact there were difficulties, you can't deny that. Difficulties, some of these were related to global issues, some were the local issues. But having said all that, a country like India continued to have a strong potential for growth. This year monsoon had been good. Now policy are coming right. In recent past, both monetary authorities and the government, being the fiscal authorities, they have taken a number of right steps. So I would be quite optimistic that soon we will see that the economy is getting back to the growth trajectory.
No,
we already, you know, we have been growing here steadily. You see, there was a time we used to have only 5-6 branches. Since then we are growing continuously, and we already have now 2 permissions on hand to open 2 more branches in City of London. One is in Slough and other is in Hounslow. So we are already in the process of opening these branches. Internationally, see, we are already in 24 countries, and we already have 100 outfits. Looking to the global environment at this point of time, our strategy would not be to move into so many new territories, but we would like to further strengthen the presence where we are already there, and we find that yes, it has been a meaningful existence.